Welcome to Acton SAT, where you can self-study to success. A while ago, a particular video about getting through on SAT math came into my attention. I wondered, does it really work? So I analyzed hundreds of questions for you, and surprisingly, the result was shocking.
No.
Let's get into this. How does the arithmetic guessing trick work as claimed by these videos? You look for patterns among answer choices and compare what terms are more popular and then eliminate the less popular options one by one. So for example, have a look at this actual SAT math problem from the sample question number 6 at Math Level 1 College Board website. Check the link below in description if you are interested. Looking at these quadratic equations, notice how the first term of x squared is identical across all 5 answer choices. So we do not have to worry about x squared. Let's observe the term 6x in the first option A. There are two 6x in option A and E, and options B, C, and D have 5x. So we can see that 5x is more popular than 6x. We can eliminate A and E. Among options B to D, we see that there are two negative 5x and one positive 5x. Negative 5x is more popular, so eliminate D. Between B and C, is it negative 6 or positive 6? We have two negative 6 for option B and D, and there is only one positive 6 for option C. Negative 6 is more popular than positive 6. Therefore, eliminate C and choose B as the answer. Is it right? Oh my god, I got it right! So, does this guessing tool really work? I tried all sample and practice problems of both Math Level 1 and 2 using the College Board website and the official study guide for these two levels. In total, I went through 360 questions, but the result was very disappointing. I was hoping that I could get at least half of my guess right, because the author of these viral videos claimed that you can get up to 55% chance of getting right answers. Out of 360 problems I tried, I could apply the guessing method to only 64 questions. I was surprised to find that I could not do the guessing game for every problem. So you can use the guessing trick method for less than 20%, which is 17.5%. In other words, you cannot do the guessing trick during the 82.5% of the whole exam. That's very bad. Why is this the case? Most answer choices were just numbers, or they followed certain patterns such as increasing or decreasing gradually. I can't guess these options with incremental or decreasing numbers. Moreover, there were some graphical answer choices, phrases, inequalities, and coordinate points that I could not apply the guessing trick. And to make things even worse, the ultimate guessing trick didn't work. Of 64 questions that I did guessing, I only got 15 right. That's about 23.8% of getting right with guessing. It's not even close to 55% of getting right as claimed by the author of the ultimate guessing trick videos. Some people commented in these videos that this guessing trick method might have been quote, patched with the new SAT because the videos were uploaded 8 years ago. However, I confirmed that all the problems were not, it didn't matter. The result was still the same because the sample problems and practice problems in the official study guide are actually from the retired problem sets in the past. While the main SAT test was changed in 2016, subject test did not change. Because the ultimate guessing trick videos show 5 multiple choices, they must be referring to Math Level 1 and 2 of the subject test. We know that there are only 4 options in main SAT. The final result of my finding was that I could apply the guessing trick to only 17.5% of the whole problem. And of these small numbers, I could only get 23.8% of them right. What do you think about these results? Do you think it's worth to use your brain power to calculate the guessing trick? Or is it better to choose one of the options right away without thinking to save the thinking energy? Please comment below and let me know what you think. There were some interesting findings when I researched about this guessing trick. As I went through 360 questions, I found some useful things when taking guesses. Eliminating one or two options based on frequency of patterns among answer choices works well. Most options are largely divided into two obvious patterns at first glance. For instance, options A and B can be fractions, and options C to E can be non-fractions. One or two options can be negative numbers, and other three are positive. It is also a good idea to eliminate one option that stands out among choices. For example, if there is only one option with a fraction, but all other 4 choices are integers, then it is highly likely that the fraction option is wrong. However, this is not 100% proven method because there are indeed rare cases where one other answer choice is the correct answer. But if you must do the guessing, I think this eliminating method is good because the first elimination of minor patterns among answer choices gives you 82.8% chance of correctly eliminating incorrect options. Although this is not the same as getting a right answer, we nonetheless have a higher chance of getting a correct choice after you eliminate one or two options. If you want to practice such elimination method, check the link below in the description and do some practice for elimination. But my advice is I'd rather select one option for all my guesses to save time and energy. And I would select B if I haven't bubbled B a lot. Why? When I analyzed 400 problems from 8 practice tests in the official study guide of Math 1 and 2, option B appeared most frequently with about 23% of entire correct answers. All 5 answer choices appear pretty much similarly, but it looks like the SAT favored B over others. I don't have enough data to generate it, but hey, it's better than nothing. Here's one more research I did. I wondered how many correct answers are in a row for each test. For example, as you serve Math Level 1 or 2, if you bubble the option A 4 times in a row, is it valid? Well, it turns out that there are no 4 consecutive correct answers. If you look at this table, I analyzed 400 problems in all 8 practice exams of official study guide of Math Level 1 and 2. There was no case that had 4 correct answers in a row, and there was only one instance of getting 3 correct answers in succession. But it was also possible that you could get no 3 correct answers in a row, so keep that in mind as well. 2 same options in a row, on the other hand, was quite popular. There were at least 5 2 same answers and at most 9 2 same answers. So if you finished bubbling all answers near the end of the test and found that you either had 4 choices in a row, or if there were 2 or more 3 consecutive same answers, doubt that one of the choices you made could be wrong. In sum, eliminating minor patterns at first glance among answer choices can be helpful. Option B appeared most frequently among 400 problems, so bubbling B might be a good idea. Lastly, 2 same answer choices appeared most frequently in each test, but 3 consecutive answer choices only happened once or none. 4 consecutive same options, on the other hand, didn't seem to be applicable to the SAT. So, did the ultimate guessing trick really work? Well, I showed you that the number of problems I could apply the guessing trick was very small, about 17.5% of all problems. And to make things worse, I could only get 23.4% of right answers with the guessing trick method. It might be a better idea to guess with the same choice to save time and energy rather than struggling to guess every question. Please let me know what you think below in comment and smash the like button and subscribe to this amazing channel. See you next time.